All right, got my new terminal on, got the battery installed, got my ghetto keychain here. One, two, three. There it is. Family Truckster is reborn. Show you the family truckster. There she is. Picked this baby up for about $2,000 from this guy Dave up in Rockport. Had about 85,000 miles on it. More importantly, there were not a single drop of anything, any kind of fluids underneath. Not too bad. It's not great, but it's all I can really do with all the crap I have. We're right by Ragged Point up here on Pacific Coast Highway. There's a condo right there.
Whoa!
I can't get my helmet.
Images you only see in dreams are here. Look out for the grizzlies. Oh, Bobby! The leg is out. I don't know how high, maybe 1,000 feet.
Let's go faster. So it makes it more dangerous. Let me show you the bits and bobs of how I put the bike in here. This is the ramp switch unfold, and I got this wheel chalk at Cycle Gear. Get my dirty underwear out of the way. Attach some ballistic nylon webbing here to the door hinge, and you gotta crank these up every once in a while. So yeah, that's it. That's how I do it. My guitars are in here, all my recording devices, my music equipment's in here. Both of my computers. Got my $10,000 workstation sitting here with a crappy towel over it. This is what I do all my final element work on, my analysis. I'm in a mechanical engineer. I own an engineering company, mostly doing aerospace type stuff. Again, I'm Portuguese, so we are the cheapest people in the world, so I wasn't going to buy anything really nice. You know, I kind of like having an unassuming vehicle. Yep, got my pillar right here, and my cooler. The 2,000 mile cleaning. You know, I don't have the
Cycle Cruiser.
I don't have the Cycle Cruiser security cameras, the solar power, or the fold-down bed. That's really nice, but I couldn't fit all that shit. What I did to compensate for that was just buy a really cheap-looking van that no one wants to steal. And what I do is to disable it, I pull the fuse for the fuel pump out, and I put a blown fuse in its place, you know, it slows people down from stealing it.
Thank you.
Police station, got the release certificate so I can get this thing out of the junkyard, and I gotta go to this place, Auto Plus Towing. Here we are in lovely Oakland. Isn't this just beautiful? This is like the place. Moe's.
Yeah, Homer. Hey, Homer. Hey, Homer.
200 feet on the left.
Is there a Hagen Kiss here? An Amanda Hagen Kiss.
Oh, there's another 5-0 over there. Look at that. That'll be my friggin' car. Ooh. Regatta Blue. I'll have to check this thing out. Convertible. Let's see what we got here. Oof. High speed, 87, 89. Little quarter damage there. Nice little patchwork on the top. Oh, that's nice. Yeah. Man, that thing is beat. This thing is filthy. Filthy. Alright, let's go get the Vantage.
Auto Plus. Yeah, Mo here.
Alright. Now we're on to the next place. Do a little video here to show you just how shitty fucking Oakland is. Look at this fucking place. This is all you see in Oakland, just about, other than if you're up in the hills up there. We're right by the Coliseum.
Okay.
Usually there's like an entire village of friggin' tents under this thing. Tents, cardboard boxes, you know, little shanty shacks. Made from whatever they can find, five sides they can cobble together. 5401, here it is. Yeah, I see it. Friggin', there's nothing in there, I can already tell. Bike's gone. What did you think, Rob? Friggin' mangled the side of it. What the fuck? Dented the side of it. What the hell? Oh, they took fucking everything. Friggin' cooler. Oh, the wheel chock's still there. Ramps are gone. Oh, the clutch cables. They didn't take that, motherfuckers. Eh, Newports. Ignition. I should have pulled the fuse, but I didn't. So they cut the battery out. I'm sure they found the fucking drill. Yep. Had a nice DeWalt drill. That's gone. Wheel chock is still here. That's good. They took the jack. I had an inverter in here, too. That's gone. Well, they left the tie downs for the handlebars. Probably didn't know what the fuck those things were. All because I didn't pull a fuse. What in the fuck is this thing? Piece to another car. Well, the officer is right. They just use them for a couple weeks and they dump them.
Dump them? Dump.
Take everything out they can. They can salvage and just dump it. This is all recovered stuff, I guess. And it's dual sport over there. DR200. 929. Look at that thing. So here's the thing about Oakland. People just dump shit everywhere. Look at this exercise bike. Nice. And no matter where you go, you're just gonna find random crap just dumped. Washing machines, tires, car batteries, clothing. All right, so we've got our 1997 Econoline here that was just stolen and recovered. I've got to put a cable end on this guy. Okay. So I'm just gonna tighten these down and that's it. Drop the battery in here. Here's some goodies. Guessing it's out of fuel. So now I got to put fuel in it. They wanted $400 at the salvage yard. They actually made a mistake and released the vehicle without me paying anything. So that would have been $700. All right. Got my new terminal on. Got the battery installed. Got my ghetto keychain here. There it is. Alright, so here's the new ignition lock cylinder. I picked this up at O'Reilly. There's really nothing to it. You just synchronize the lock cylinder to the run position and the ignition housing to the run position and align the splines. Okay, push it in all the way. That's it. So if you wanted to steal a car, all you really need to do is shear this pin off. In this case, they actually, instead of shearing that pin off, they actually fractured this sleeve, this casting, and then extracted the ignition. So you can see, it wouldn't actually take that much force to shear this pin to extract this ignition. You could use a slide hammer and then, you know, break this off, this outer bezel, and then you just jam a slide hammer, screw a slide hammer into the end of the ignition, and then just hammer it out.
Insert it between the chrome facade and the column and knock it off. Take your slide hammer and screw it down into ignition. You want to get it tight or until the slide hammer, the sheet metal screw, has sunk all the way in to this ignition switch. And then you'll begin slide hammering the ignition out of the steering column.
The man you'll meet in this video is an expert at taking cars that don't belong to him. Because of his expertise in his field, news organizations such as the Los Angeles Times, the Orange County Register, Orange Coast Magazine, and many more publications have written stories about him. He's 31 years old and has more than 8 years in his line of work. During that time, he's taken any car a client was willing to pay for. As you'll see, he doesn't need the keys to unlock an automobile and drive it down the street. This includes yours. Hi, I'm Bill Banks, and I'll be your host for the next hour. I'd like to tell you a little more about Mr. Smith. He has a reputation for being very professional about his work. He started out taking old cars that weren't used for much more than parts and graduated to the best cars on the road.
My colleagues believe that I'm wasting my time with you, but I believe you wish to do the right thing.
Here's what you do. Tomorrow you borrow my car.
You don't lend anybody your car.
It's all right. I'm going to lend you my car. I want you to make a good impression. You borrow my car, and then you give it a test.
What, the Mario test?
Mario. Mario's a fucking psycho. What do you listen to this kid for? You give him my test. You give it a door test.
What's the door test?
All right, listen to me. You pull her right where she is, right? Before you get out of the car, you lock both doors. Then you get out of the car, you walk over to her. You bring her over to the car. You take out the key, put in the lock, open the door for her. Then you let her get in. Then you close the door for her. Then you walk around the back of the car and you look through the rear window. If she doesn't reach over, lift up that button for you so you can get in, dump her.
Just like that?
Listen to me, kid. If she doesn't reach over, lift up that button for you so you can get in, that means she's a selfish broad and all you're seeing is the tip of the iceberg. You dump her and you dump her fast.
Yeah, what about all the beautiful things you just told me, though? Do what my heart tells me to do. It's all that matters. Find someone to pull into myself. I mean, hey, this could be one of the great ones.
Bullshit, kid. The door test, that's what counts. You dump her and you dump her fast.
Dump her?
Dump her.
Dump her?